or just looking at different recipes and when those recipes might be useful or different situations where you might be find yourself in and wanting a good recipe for it.
Yes, so we started today with the series last month. And this is the second one that last month we talked about or looked at landscapes. And this month we are looking at cityscapes. So anything, you know, anything, street photography, I guess. And, you know, Richie, do you want to give us a bit of a...
There's nothing more iconic than Kodachrome 64 for street photography. So if you find yourself downtown with your camera and you're wanting to do some street photography and it's daylight, the Kodachrome 64 recipe is my recommendation for that situation. So I think it produces lovely colors and you'll get some of those iconic looks from some of the great street photographers in the past. You'll be able to kind of produce a similar aesthetic to that using this recipe. So for street photography and it's daylight, you're downtown, you know, program that Kodachrome 64 recipe in and have fun.
Yes. Well, I'm definitely looking forward to this. I think I'm definitely a Kodachrome kind of girl. So I can't wait to give this one a try. And I'm not sure if there's anything else. On the app, it looks like this. If there's anything else that you want to add that people can look out for, definitely share it.
Yeah, if you go to the website, within the app at the bottom, there's a link to the website and you can go see the article and it talks a little bit more about Kodachrome film, about using this recipe, some different suggestions and that kind of thing. And you see a lot more sample images of what you're going to look like. And you can see in even that picture that you just passed, even if the sun has gone down and it's blue hour, you could still get some really good results using this recipe.
Yeah. I love all the sample images so that you can really get an idea and all the background information on it. So again, super cool. Super cool. The combination between the app and the website.
Yeah, I appreciate that. And so the next one is if you're out at night, this recipe was modeled after a certain photographer's aesthetics. Jeff Davenport has done some wonderful night images, and I made this recipe to mimic his look. So if you find yourself at night in downtown in a city environment and are looking to do some night photography, this recipe produces some really wonderful results. And I also want to point out that on the community recipes page, someone has shared their alternate version of this, which doesn't look like Jeff Davenport's pictures, but it looks really cool. So that if you're looking for a little bit alternate version, be sure to go to the community's recipe page and find that and try both, you know, see what you like.
Cool. Excellent. So much to try. And this is not everything. We've got a third one, which is more for daytime downtown. Yeah.
So we looked at street photography. This one I wouldn't necessarily use for actual street photography, but just doing more like cityscapes. And I love this recipe is one that I really personally like a lot. I feel like it's kind of underutilized, underappreciated. It produces some really great results. I've used it in downtown. I've used it at like walking around a university, but it's just it just produces really lovely pictures. And Fujicolor 100 Industrial is kind of one of those films that is the actual film itself can be hard to find because I believe it was only made available in Japan. But some people have sold it on the internet, you know, internationally, but it's mostly only found in Japan. But it what's unique about it is that it's actually a tungsten balanced film where they then shifted the colors to make it daylight balance. So it's kind of, and that's what I've modeled it after with the white balance. If you notice, the white balance uses a very cool white balance, but then in the shift, shifts it way towards warm mm-hmm. and balances it out. So it's pretty interesting.
Okay, very cool. I love to get all that insight behind all those film simulations and just to pick up a little bit on history.
Yeah. So if you're downtown photographing, you know, make sure that you program in Kodachrome 64, the Jeff Davenport Night, and the Fujicolor 100 industrial recipes into your camera.
Yes. And best take a screenshot right now so that you have a visual memory of it and, you know, get shooting.